Hi friends, welcome to Jenkins series. So as of now, we learned lot of things, how to generate test reports, how to create the pipeline, and you know how to send email notification. Lot of things we learned till now, right? So if in the real time in the software industry, we do not have only single job. If you are running on the microservice architecture, we have a lot of services, right? Maybe admin service, security service, like a card service, payment service, right? So all services will be depend on one job is depend on another job will be depend on another job, right? So if you want to run individually, you need to run individually, but once this job is done, first job, once this job is completed, you need to intimate to another job, hey, once your job is completed, let me know, then I will start my job. In that way, if you want to give one pipeline, say it's called a delivery pipeline, okay? So that delivery pipeline, how to create, I'm giving a small example, like right now I can't create number of services, right? So what I will do, simple echo commands with some clean or test or deploy some commands, so that you will have an idea, okay, there is a delivery pipeline concept is also available in the Jenkins. To know about that concept, I'm explaining in this session, okay? So if you see here, we have a Maven goals, right? First you need to clone the project, then you need to clean, then you need to test, then you need to deploy. This is your job, okay? So real, it's not working. These are like echo commands we will do, okay? See, first it is a clean command. First I will, in the echo statement in the shell script, I will write as a clean job. After this job is completed, then you need to start this job, then you need to start this job. Then how to configure this one, I will explain in this section, okay? In order to support this action, if you want to see the delivery pipeline, you need to install a plugin. Before installing the plugin, I will create the jobs, then I will explain how to install the plugin, okay? So let me open system, okay? So create a new item. So what name we will give, we can give as a delivery underscore maven underscore clean. I'm giving, this is my job name, okay? This is a freestyle project, click okay. And click on build. Just I'm giving some echo statement. So as of now, you know how to create cloning, doing these things. You can do like R&D, execute the shell. Here I can give as a echo command, I will give, okay? This is which job? Maven clean completed. Some statement I given, Maven clean completed. Okay, next, just save this job, that's it, okay? Now click on the build. Now the job will be a trigger. This is the initial step, okay? I will create another job, another two jobs. I will create the new item. Here you can provide the name as which name, instead of clean I will give as a test. So instead of creating everything, what I will do, click on the copy from where you want to copy. Okay, you already pasted, okay? I want to copy from this job, okay? Click okay. All configurations will be same. Click on the build environment. Instead of clean, I need to do the test. Same set of configuration you need in another job, you can copy from existing one. You don't need to configure everything, okay? Just save. This is another job, okay? I will click on the build now. Next. I will create another job, click the new item, and here just paste it. This is for the deploy. This is not like a real time, I'm giving just a dummy configuration, okay, to know the concept. Here you can copy it from clean, just okay. Go for the build environment. And here I will write as a deploy, okay? Maven deploy completed. Now what you will do, click on save. Now three jobs you created, okay? Now build now. So if you want to run these three jobs, you are running manually, right? So maven clean, maven deploy, maven test. What I need after cleaning, automatic trigger my second job. It should trigger the next job. How to configure means, first job you no need to configure, go for the second job, test is my second job, right? Click on the configure. There is a build trigger. Click on the build trigger. Here if you see, build after other projects are built. Click here. Okay, which is your project? Delivery. If you type here, you will get the after cleaning, which one I need to run? Clean is my parent job. Okay, just remove this comma. Okay, just clean, just save it. Okay, this is your upstream job. This is my second job, and there is one more job, deploy. Okay, when after test, deploy need to be run, right? Go for the configure, click on the build trigger. There is an option, build after projects are built. Here you can write your delivery. When this job should be run? After test job, it needs to run my deploy job. First clean job, second is test, then deploy. Okay, and save. Now three jobs are you configured. What I will do, 3 minutes ago, 1 minute ago, 2 minutes ago, what I will do, just go and trigger this job, build now. What will happen, just observe. So my clean job is running now, and if you observe here, his job is run. 10:16 it ran. Okay, and one more, this is my deploy job. See, 10:16 it ran. See, if you see here, after running the job, my upstream job is which one? Delivery, maven test is my upstream job. And if you go down for that test, okay, for my test project, upstream is maven clean, downstream is deploy. So this is the way you need to configure your delivery pipeline. Okay, to see the GUI, if you want to see the UI representation, I will explain this configuration in the next video. I hope you are clear. We'll see you in the next tutorial. Thank you guys.